Hi everybody, this is Ellen. In this tutorial I'm going to show you how to make a happy bowl of cereal. This cereal happens to be Fruit Loops, very tasty but not very good for you. I think it's super cute and I made a little spoon to go with it. Nom nom nom. It's not super band heavy, which I like, and I just think it turns out super cute. It looks awesome. Band wise, there are, for the bowl color, it's 218, and then for all of the Fruit Loops on the inside, or the cereal on the inside, it's 9 each for, you make 12 of them, so that comes out to a total of 78 bands for all the different colors. So, and I'll write in the description box below kind of a better breakdown of what I mean by that, but like, you make 2 purple Fruit Loops, so it's 18 purple, you know, so like that. And then, although you can't see it because I've filled my bowl very full, there is technically a layer in here that would be like the milk color for white. And as I just showed you, you don't really see it, so it's kind of up to you whether or not you want to actually do that. So, put my cereal back in my bowl. But it tucks down inside. Super cute! Then I use 9mm pony beads for the eyes. So those are the larger normal size pony beads. If not, you can use two bands wrapped for the eyes and then the cheeks and the mouth. So we'll get started making a few things ahead of time and I'll show you how to do that. My little spoon. The spoon, if you want to make it, I'll run through how to do it at the end, but it was 23 bands to make it, so I thought they kind of went cute together. So, but we need to make the cheeks. To make those, it is whatever color you want to be the cheek, and you'll have the colors for your bowl. So you take your cheek band on your hook, wrap it around one time into a figure eight, grab both bands, wrap them around again, and then pull through two bands that are the color of your bowl. Like that. So you want to make 2 cheek bands. For the eyes, since I'm using the larger ones, I don't have to put the bands in ahead of time, I'll do it while I'm looming. But if you don't have the beads, you can use 2 bands, the color of your eye, on your hook, wrap it around to the figure eight, then grab all 4 bands, wrap them around again, and then once again pull through 2 bands that are the color of your bowl. Like that. So you make 2 of those for the eyes if you don't have the beads. And then we have our Fruit Loops cereals. They're simply doubled band little loops. And to make those, you can still use the rainbow loom hook, but I'm actually going to use the latch hook because it's a little quicker. But you want to take 1 band, put it on your hook, wrap it around one time to the figure eight, grab both bands, wrap them around again, like that. And then we're going to double the bands and then chain up 8 more, or 7 more, so that we have a total of 8. So on the hook, wrap it around till we have it doubled, and then you'll slide through what's on your hook. Put both ends back on, and do that until we have a total of 8, including the cap band. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And 8. So once you have 8, you'll take the end with the cap band, you'll slide it back onto the hook, make sure you get through all 4 bands, slide that down, then you'll take another band on the hook, double it, and pull it through everything on your hook, back on. And then you do a slip knot to close it, and that's all to make the little Fruit Loop. Like that. So as you can see, I have 2 of each color of the rainbow ready to go for mine. like, this will be another bowl of Fruit Loops, but, like, earlier I was playing around and I made some different ones to make, like, the trick cereal that I remember, which was the round ones, not the weird-shaped ones now, but I just made little ball things. So, I mean, there's tons of different ways that you can make the cereal that goes in the bowl. Make these all kind of brown or light tan color. Make them Cheerios. Anything that you like for breakfast, you can come up with a way to make some of those. So, we will get started. It is on one loom. I have the wrong end facing towards me. And we're going to start with the bands that'll be on the inside that I call the milk bands. And like I said, it doesn't really matter. You can make them all the bowl color too. They'll hide well. So, but I make it so that you can have the two different colors be different, just so it's possible. We're gonna start in the middle of the loom. So, probably the seventh pin up somewhere around here. So come over to the center. We're gonna make starburst here. So everything's double banded unless I say differently, but it's two bands. And we're just gonna go around from the center pin. And I guess I should pause, or I should tell you that you probably need to pause and make the Fruit Loops ahead of time because we do use those right away. Sorry about that. Get excited. Share my cereal. So make your starburst. On the center pin, we're going to make a cap band. Two bands wrapped around three times. So one, two, and three. And then, before we loop the starburst out, we're going to attach our Fruit Loops. And how we're going to do that is just, I tried to make them so that the colors weren't like right next to each other. And by doing that, I basically started with red here and then went around all the way with the rainbow. And we're just using that little tail part that we had left over from closing it. We just take them and go all the way around. And you can put them on any way you want for whatever order, but so go like that. And then right over the top of these, I kind of shifted it a little bit, so the next one I'm going to put right on top of the red is going to be a yellow one. And then green, blue, purple, and then just kind of go backwards, so green. And I don't know why I didn't just shift it over and start with the red, but you know, we'll just make it all. I guess I just always think of this as a starting point over here, so. But this way the colors aren't too close to each other when they're in the cereal bowl. So once you add this, then you go in through your cap band, grab the top two bands wherever they are, pull them up through the center and back towards themselves, and you'll do that all the way around the starburst. Like that. It should look like this. So now we're going to do is you're just going to take your cereal and you're just going to take the bands and slide them up over the top of the pin so they're resting in the middle there. And you do that all the way around. Like that. I usually push these bands back down because they slide up. Then using the milk color again if you want, we're going to do a row all the way around with two bands. Try and keep your cereal in the center. You can pull them out later if they get stuck in there, but it's all the way around. Then you go and grab the bottom four bands on all the pins and pull them up over the top on all of them. Push those down, and now we're going to expand all of our pins. And how we're going to do that, so I'll start over here on the right, and it's basically that we want the, hopefully your bands are similar to mine. For this one right here, I can just pick up the top two bands and bring them up a pin. There's no crossing of the bands, and I'll show you what it looks like down below so you know what not to do, but they're separated right here by just the band that we flipped over the center part there. So that one's fine. But down here, if I was to take the top two bands and pull them down, you see how it crosses there? We don't want that. So what we have to do when it looks like that is I just pick up all the bands. I'm gonna bring them down a pin. And then I'll bring the top two bands back up. So now again, there's no crossing of these bands right here. And if you look, the band that's on this pin actually comes around to this pin, and that's what we want it to look like. So we'll go over to the left side, and it should be the opposite from what you did on the other side. So this top one up here, I can't just pick up the top two, I have to pick up all of them, bring them up a pin, and then I can grab the top two and bring them back down. And this lower one, I should be able to grab the top two and bring them down. So again, it looks just like the other side. There's no crossing. And this band that's on this pin comes around to this pin. So our center ones we have left. So with these, you can just go in, pick up the top two bands. And I can see that the ones on my hook are attached to this pin. So I'm just going to bring them up over to the left. So the ones left on the pin are going to go over to the right. And you do the same thing down below. Just pick up the top two. Mine are on the left, so I'll bring them over to the left side. And then the other ones on the pin are going to come to the right. So you have two bands on six pins on each side. So we're going to do a row all the way around this. Again with the milk color, two bands. I realize now that I'm using white on white for this part, hopefully you can see it well. I have a different camera I'm using this time, so we'll see how this turns out when I'm all finished. Just hope I'm recording. That'd be awkward. It's not like my other one. I guess I should just say I upgraded my phone, which I used to record, so a little bit different. The other one actually go to video and then I could stop and start from that, but like this one I so like that all the way around. So now you flip over the bottom two on all the pins. But this one it's like always on the camera face or always on the camera screen, and then you can like slide it over to video and it starts recording like right away. And then when you press stop it goes back to the camera screen. It's kind of weird. I guess maybe it's to make it quicker, so if you're trying to catch something to record something real quick, you'll be able to do it without having to fumble for more buttons, I guess. I don't know. So like that. Push those down. So now what we're going to do, as we are done with the milk color, unless you're still planning on using the white for the bowl like I did on this one, you just continue using white for the rest of this, everything that I do. But if you want to change the color of your bowl, which I'm going to do here, what we need to do now is we're going to puff our milk bands with the bowl bands. And how we do that, so I have two bands. I'm going to go in through the bands that are on the pin, grab the two bands that are the color of my bowl. If you're using going to do a white bowl. You use the white here as well. But you put them on the on your hook, bring them up through, put both ends back on, and then you'll take the bands, the milk bands off the pin, and then the bowl bands that are on your hook, they're going to go on the pin instead. And you do that all the way around on every pin. Through the bands, pull up your bowl bands, both ends on the hook, slide off the milk bands, bowl bands go back onto the pin. And just do that all the way around. Takes a little while, it's kind of a pain, but it works wonders, so. For a nice transition. Earlier today when I was playing on my phone, when I can't do anything else, but the kids are content and happy playing, so I get to do something for a moment. Just flipping through Facebook, and there was a video on there of a couple who were doing a surprise gender reveal. So like they had their baby, and they're in the hospital, and all the family members were coming to see what it was after all their guessing of whether it was a boy or a girl. And this couple, they actually had twins, so they were surprising everybody with the fact that there was two babies instead of one. I loved it. It was awesome. Such a great secret to be able to keep. And then like the looks on these people's faces when they walk in the room, they're just like, oh my god, no way. And you know, the shocked looks, it was priceless. It'd be pretty awesome. I think now that I've have four kids, I don't know if I could, unless I had met, somehow had twins, I don't think I could get that quite of a surprise out of telling people whether it was a boy or a girl. But it was adorable. I loved it. So like that, all of them are puffed. Make sure you push these down as far as they go, because they are going to be on the loom while we do the next portion, and they kind of, hopefully they won't get in your way too much, but they will be there. So now what we're going to do is an X row all the way around. So it's two bands, your bowl color, everything from now on is going to be the bowl color. Two bands, and you just take the band, put it on, but give it a twist so you have a little, so it turns into an X, and we'll do that all the way around this portion. Those puffing bands, those ones that are still on the pins, we're going to ignore those for the time being, so. Like that, cross row all the way around. You want to push these down. Now we're going to do another row right on top of this with the two bands just normally across. And there are a lot of bands on the pin, but once we kind of get through the first couple rows like this, it gets easier to spot them when we're doing the flipping, so. That. So now what we're going to do is we're going to flip the bands, but we're going to only flip the middle four bands. So the top four are from this normal row that we just put on. The middle four bands are the crossed row, and then the bottom four are the puffing bands. So you want to leave those where you can kind of smoosh them down. But we only want the middle four bands. So find those and flip them over the top. And there will be times when you'll grab like a puffing band or something, but just take your time. It helps too, like I can see these two bands easily. And then once I pull those over, I can see the other bands to flip to. And we'll always go back to check in between to make sure that we don't have anything looped that we're not supposed to. Like that. Then you just want to go in and make sure that nothing is connected together on the inside. It's a little hard to tell, but if you kind of push down the serial, you'll see that there's a space there. Just make sure that there aren't any of the puffing bands flipped over the top as well. So do that every time after a row. So push those down again. Then we're going to do another row all the way around, two bands just like before. Like that. And then you'll go in and we'll flip the middle four again. So just find that middle four, flip them over the top. It was really hard choosing a bowl color because like most of my own dinnerware is white. So I was like, oh, I gotta do white. But I really like the idea of kind of being able to have the little milk on the inside, little extra touch. It's like, so what color do I make? And then it's like, well, I used all the rainbow colors in the Fruit Loops, so I didn't want to have any of those exactly the same as the Fruit Loops. It was a long, hard decision, sadly enough, but I like my choice, I think. So again, make sure that you don't have any that are connected where they're not supposed to be. Push your bands down. Our next row is going to be our eye row. So you want your eyes, whether they'll be the wrap bands or the beads. So I'm going to start here with the two bands across. Two more bands. This next spot is going to be an eye. And then we'll have normal bands and then another eye and then normal bands. So. But I can just squish these flat and thread them through the center of the bigger pony beads, so. Like that. And then two bands. And the other one. And then the rest of the way around is two bands. Earlier today, my oldest, after school, he had to go to Boy Scouts, like that. And then again, we'll flip that middle four. But he went to Boy Scouts, and then my middle son, he went to a friend's house for the evening. And then, so it was just my husband and the two youngest here. And I took my little Violet to the bookstore with me, and my husband stayed, and he and Grayson, they cleaned off the bike trailer because it's now spring again, so they can get out and, or my husband can get out, and he likes to haul them around on the bike trailer. But they're cleaning it out there, and it's like, I think my husband forgets every time that spring comes around and what children do with the hose when you let them have it. But he just was spraying it down, and then he just kind of handed it to Grayson to do with what he wanted. And of course that was meant spray everything and everybody. It's kind of silly, I think. It was funny. So my husband was soaked, but... Alright, so our next row is going to be our cheek row. So you want your cheeks. Cheeks will go in the same place as the eyes, so it's just the same as before. I'll do a row around, just putting cheeks where the eyes go. I realized as I was telling that story, I didn't do it enough justice for how hilarious it was, because... my husband was soaked completely, and Grayson's just there holding it and laughing, and my husband's trying to get it from him, and he thinks it's hilarious, but I'm sure it was cold, because it's not quite that warm yet. Where getting sprayed with the hose would not be a little chilly. That. And the cheek ones really kind of want to pop up just because they're by the eyes, so just make sure that they're on there good. Then again, we'll go and flip the middle four. But I took my daughter with me to the bookstore to get some more books because I'm definitely in a book reading mood lately for whatever reason, and I read much too fast. I need to go to the library is what I need to do, but I like going to the bookstore, I guess. I like owning books. Maybe it makes me feel smart or something, I don't know. But went to Books A Million, which is, it's like they don't just have books, you know, they gotta have every other little toy and pillows and socks and just everything. So now you have those flipped over. We're going to go back around and we're going to flip the puffed bands over the top as well. I didn't want to do it all at once because it kind of gets too messy, but now you can go grab those four puff bands and flip those over the top. Let's do that all the way around. But my daughter, she is, I'm hoping that I'm not spoiling her, but she's kind of a little diva, and she likes to have her way, and she was, normally it's not, like most of my kids, I could give them something to play with or to look at while we're in a store, and then we can leave, and it's no big deal. They're just like, you know, they don't need it, and they know that it's not a big deal. So once you get all those flipped over, push them down. And you want to pop this up over the pin to keep it towards the center. Try not to hook the edge of this because that'll kind of make the edge of the bowl kind of goofy. And then push those down. Now we want to put on the mouth. So mouth band. It's going to be stretched between these two pins here. So I'll take the band on my hook, wrap it around one time to the figure eight. Then I'm going to take my hook, go through the bands that are on the, I guess, the right middle section, pull them off, slide down my mouth band, and then I'll put the bands on my hook back onto the pin. So it looks like that. Then I'll grab the bands and kind of pull them over towards the other one just so they're loose. I'm going to take my hook, go in through the bands on the next pin over, pull them up. And if I grab these and just kind of pull them straight across, I need more fingers, pull them straight across, and if I lift it up, catch that bottom, the bottom two bands on that pin, and then bring it forward, it does this little cross. You can see there. So it looks like that. And that is so that you want to test this before you actually put the bands back on the pin, because otherwise you'll be like, ah, it's backwards or it's crossed. But you want it to look like this. And how, when we put the bands back onto the pin, you're going to take this band and flip it up over the pin, and it'll look like that. So make sure that when you grab this band and flip it back, it'll look like it's going straight across. And if you cross it the wrong way, you'll definitely see there'll be a cross in the center of the bands, the mouth band. So make sure it looks like that. Then you can put the bands back onto the pin. Make sure you get all of them back on there. And then you take this and flip it up. So it looks like it's going across. Like so. So now we're going to do another row all the way around with two bands. Just normally. Can't remember where I was with my story. Well, Miss Violet, she can play with things, and she will let them go if she doesn't, you know, fairly easily. But when she's not ready to, she has the most blood-curdling scream ever. And normally I don't give her anything to play with in the store because I know that she will do that. So, but we were, I was had my back turned looking at some books, and she was sitting in the stroller, and she grabbed a hold of these wooden snakes that kind of like slither. And so she had that, and she was playing with it, and she started kind of using it as a whip. Like that, all the way around. Flip the bottom four. Which, you know, maybe in a store like Walmart, where nobody would really notice all the extra noise, might be fine. But when you're in a bookstore, it's kind of noticeable. So I tried convincing her to let me have it so we could put it back on the shelf, and she just was not in the mood for that at all. So she starts screaming. So then it's like, you know, you feel like you're like, okay, you need her to be quiet because people around are going to get kind of upset because it's a bookstore and they're trying to read. But you don't want to be the bad parent that like gives in to their kid and lets them have whatever they want and, you know, sure, have it, be quiet. So what do you do? Now we're going to do another row all the way around again, just like that. And we're getting close to being done. So, then you can let me know with my stories. But so, what I ended up doing is I convinced her that she would rather have a pillow instead. Lovely that BAM sells pillows. But it was this cute little, well, not really little, but cute flower pillow is the one she wanted. I tried to convince her that she wanted this cute little elephant, but she didn't want that one. She wanted the flower. So once she had that, she just like put it in her stroller and laid back on it and just like zoned out. And I'm like, okay, this is good, but it's all the way around. And again, we'll flip the bottom four. I'm like, okay, so it's good. She's quiet. She's being a good girl. She's relaxed. I can finish looking at my books. So we can go. But I'm like, oh, I feel like such a bad parent right now because I feel like I just totally gave in to her tantrum, which I probably did, but switching out the noisy snake that she's beating things with and screaming with when I'm trying to take it away for a soft pillow that she can't do much damage with, I kind of feel like I won too. Alright, so you want to push these down, and now we want to bring the center up, because this is a growing up design. So I'm going to take my hook, and I'm going to go in, and I'm going to find the cap band from the milk section, and I'm going to pull that up. And it won't totally release everything. You'll have to go in and go around and release stuff from around the sides. Just try not to pull too much with your hook on any one specific band. Otherwise, like I said, you'll get like a... the bands around the outside of the bowl will get kind of goofy. Get your fingers in there. You can, there is a little edge here to grab a hold of and to pull up the bowl. Just be careful how hard you're pulling so you don't end up pulling it anything off the loom. It should come up like that. Because now what we're going to do is we need to reduce Make sure these are tucked in on the ends too, around the pins on both sides. Now what we're going to do is reduce, and we're going to start by reducing the third pin up on the right, so this pin right here. This time we want the bands to cross when we take them off, so I'm going to pick up the top two bands, and I see that if I tug on them, I can see they're coming from the upper pin, so I want them to come all the way and cross down to the lower pin. So the two bands that are left on this pin, they'll be coming from the lower pin, so I'm going to bring them up to the upper pin, like that. And then again, up here on the top right, we'll reduce this one. I'm going to grab the top two bands, and you can see they're coming from the left side over here, so I'm going to bring them to the right. And then the other two bands, they'll be coming from the right, so they're going to go over to the left. Now, we're going to reduce the third one down on the left side, so this one right here. Grab the top two bands, and they're coming from the lower pin, so I'm going to bring them to the upper pin. And yours might be arranged differently if you put them on the loom differently, but just always to see where they're coming from and pull them to the pin farther away. So these ones on here, they're coming from the upper, so they're going to go to the lower. Like that. And our last one is going to be this bottom left pin. So you grab the top two bands. Mine are coming from the left, so I'm going to cross them over to the right. And then the ones left on the pin are going to go to the left. Like that. So push your bands down. And kind of see if I can't really squish it with my fingers out of the way. Squish. You kind of see you have the reduced bands between here and then on the ends. So we want to do a row all the way around. So the first one is going to be, it's still two bands, but it's going to stretch from the left all the way to the right. Next one up is just going to be two bands normal. Next one is over the three pins. Then two bands normal. And a long stretch. And normal. And a long stretch here. And then two normal. So look like this. So now we're going to flip the bands. This, I'm going to start on the left side and go down. But the top left will have four of the reducing bands, and then, or no, sorry, two reducing bands. I had to check there. Two reducing bands, and then the four normal bands. Next one down, we'll have two reducing bands, and then four bands, two reducing bands, and then four bands. And you can flip these back over to the inside when you go by them after you've loomed the ones around it. And here we have reducing bands, four. And we'll come from the right and go up. It'll be same thing, just opposite. The reducing bands, and then four. And again, flip that towards the center or over the pin. Reducing bands, four bands, reducing bands, four bands. And reducing bands and four bands. And flip that over. And that one. Like that. Push your bands down, and we're going to reduce one last time. So we're going to start with this one right here on the lower right. And if you kind of see they're in sections, like here's two, 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 and two. We're going to take the first one in this section. So grab the top two bands, see where they're coming from. Mine are coming from the right, so they're going to cross over to the left. And then the other ones will go to the right. And then we'll take this next one. Grab the top two bands. If it'll let you. Top two bands. And it's a little harder to see on the sides where they're coming from, but this one is coming from the top. So it's going to stretch all the way down to below, to the first one on the right side. So it's a long stretch, but it's not horrible bad. So like that. And then the other one left is going to go up to the pin above. So it'll look like that on the right side. Now I go over to the other side. So I'm going to take the top left, grab the top two bands, and they are coming from the left, so they're going to come over to the right, and the other two bands are going to come to the left. And then we'll go down to this pin, grab the top two bands, see where they're coming from. They're coming from below, so they're going to stretch all the way up. And then the other ones on the pin will stretch all the way down. So it is a long stretch, but they'll be alright. I haven't broken any bands doing that yet, so to look like that. We're on four pins now. So we're going to do a row around, two bands all the way around. And this is a very long stretch on the sides. Look like that. So now on every pin, you're going to have four reducing bands. That's why I had the four stuck in my head from before. Four reducing bands and then the four below that. I always do the reducing bands first. So if you can see which one's on top, it's a little bit easier. So this one's on top, so I'll flip that reducing band. There's two there. Flip the reducing band from the other side, and then I'll do the four below. If you try and flip them all at once, it's kind of a little hard on your hook. So here are these two reducing bands on the top. Here's the other two reducing bands. And then we have the four below. And again, you can flip these towards the center. And do the same thing on the other side. These two reducing bands, and these two, and the four below, these two, and this four, put those towards the center, and then you can tuck pull this up. Be careful not to pull it up, but you want it to, like right here it's kind of overlapped, you want to pull it so it's away. Make sure it's like that on both sides. So we are only on four pins and we're going to take it off our loom now. We are done. So I'm just going to use my rainbow loom hook and I'll go in through each corner all the way around. And you have this. I'll take two bands, pull them through everything on my hook. Both ends on, make that slip knot, pull it tight, and yes, I know it looks like something else right now, but it's going to be a bowl of cereal. I'm going to stick my hook up through, grab my two tail bands, pull them up through, and I snag something else. But then, what I do usually is I take it and I kind of turn it inside out. That's my tail band. I didn't forget a band. Turn it inside out. And you'd have a totally cool hat with an upside down face on it. But then what I do is I kind of stretch it out a little bit. And I'll just kind of hold my thumbs on the inside where the milk is. and then just tuck it back up. Because then that hides the cereal inside the bowl nicely. You don't have to worry about trying to squish it down in or fit it back in. Oh, he looks so frowny. I like that. And if things don't, if they don't fit in there, just tuck them in the side. You can curl back the edge of the bowl. And just make them how you want them to look. It took me a while to get them positioned how I was like, that looks like a bowl of cereal to me. So I want them to be kind of natural, but not natural, if that makes sense. So, like four Fruit Loops don't line up by themselves. Make me do it again, aren't you? All right, do it again. That's better. I like that. Oh, he looks so sad. I need to fix his mouth. So like that, you tuck it in. I'll fix the mouth here so he doesn't look quite so sad. There, that's better. So now we have a lovely bowl of cereal. Super cute. I love them. And then I did show you that I did say that I would show you how to make the spoon. Fairly simple. It's double band, so that's the only thing that kind of makes it take a while. So I'm using gray for it. So I want to double all the bands that I put on here. But I'll start at this point. And this is the loom with the right end towards me this time. I know, it's confusing. But we're going to go out to the left. Up one. Two. And then the third one, we're going to come back towards the center. Like that. Then we're going to do the same thing, but on the other side. The double band still. Cat hair. So like that. And then I just went down the center. Double band. Like that. And then I did a double band, but I stretched it over these three pins right here. So I think the easiest way is just get that stretch all the way across first, and then just tuck it up. And that should be enough to hold the center of it. And then I just went down the loom, eight doubled bands in the middle. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. And then the last one here, I did a cap band. That was quadrupled, so put it on one, two, three, and four. So that's what it should look like. And we'll turn this around. You go in through your cap band, grab the two bands, loom them up, and do that all the way up to the spoon, or the end of the spoon. Or the eating part of the spoon, I guess it depends what side you consider as the end. So there. Then you'll loom up, grab the top two bands, which are just one doubled band actually. But grab those, and you can just loom them all the way up the center. So for this one right here, you'll push the doubled band back, grab those two bottom bands, pull them up, loom them over, Again, push this one back, grab those bands, bring them up, and come back to where the side ones are. Grab the top two, whatever they are, loom them back up to the center point. And again, I pushed this band back when I went in through here. Like that. Do the same thing on the other side. And I push that back. Like that. Now I'll take my hook, put it in through the top, take them off, pull this off. I'll take a band on my hook, double it, pull it through everything on my hook, back on, make a slip knot, like that. And then we'll hide our little tail. Let's weave it in through somewhere. But then if you pull this out, kind of push out the middle part, it does kind of get a little cupping effect to it. I don't know if you can see it there, but it's not like super sturdy. I mean, I probably would have doubled it if I would have made it on the hook or things like that, but I think it's effective for the prop needed for the bowl of cereal. So I hope that you love these. I think they're super adorable, and I just love all the cereal. And like I said, you can change the cereal up however you want, different colors, or I know I didn't show you how to make them, but I just made little balls for what would be like, you can make them brown for like Cocoa Puffs if you put them together. There's lots of different ways to make different cereals, so totally adorable. Maybe I'll make a couple or make a video showing how to make different cereals to put into the bowl, I guess, so. But I hope that you enjoy them. I think they're super cute, and they're definitely happy food, adorable, worthy. So, but I want to thank you guys very much for watching. I definitely appreciate it. And if you make some of these, I'd love for you to share them with me on my Instagram, which is at CraftingFantastic, or on my Facebook, which is feelinspiffy or CraftingFantastic. They both should find me. And then, of course, it would be fantastic if you would give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, and tell everybody else about my channel, because it's awesome. I'm still so, I am super humbled, but I'm also super stoked, so it's really a hard balance to beat. But thank you guys so much. I definitely appreciate it, and I will have more for you soon.